So I'm back with my fridge compressors from the last video, and if you didn't see it, there is a link in the description. In the last video I was explaining how they work, and today I'm going to try to measure how much vacuum it can actually pull, to see if I'm able to use it as a vacuum pump. I've got a vacuum gauge, which came in a nice box, and it's from eBay, and it cost me only $3.90 including shipping. It's probably not very accurate, but let's try to use it. It has a brass screw on it, which is not very useful for me, so I put some rubber tape over it and I put a syringe on it to be able to fit a hose to it like this. It's a very makeshift solution, but it may actually work. It's a vacuum gauge, so the needle is normally at the right side of it, and when there is a suction, it goes to the left. And it's a relative gauge, it's measuring the relative pressure. The measurement is relative to the ambient pressure, so now it's showing zero, and when there is a suction, it will show a negative pressure. It's definitely not the best tool for this, it would be better to use an absolute pressure gauge, but let's try it. So let's try the older compressor now. Let's turn it on. And it's pumping. It's reaching about half of the atmospheric pressure. Still pumping. Now it's getting to about minus 0.8 atmosphere, which means there is about 20% of pressure remaining. And still pumping. It may seem slow for the tiny volume of the gauge, but keep in mind that the compressor is also evacuating the entire envelope of it. So basically it's not only sucking from this one, it's also sucking from the entire metal can. So the volume it has to pump out is quite big. And it's reaching about 8% of pressure, or 8 kilopascals, or 80 millibars. Now it's no longer blowing, there is no more air coming out. So it seems it reaches the maximum vacuum, or the minimum pressure. And it stops at about 80 millibars. Now let's try the other one. It's pumping. Now it's about half of the pressure and still going down. This one is more noisy. About 20% of pressure remaining. 15% of the pressure remaining. Heading for about 10%. And still slowly going down. It reaches about 8% of the pressure, or 80 millibars. Given that the atmospheric pressure is 1 bar, or 1000 millibars. And of course this is not very accurate, especially at a very low pressure, because it's relative to the atmospheric pressure here. So it reaches about 80 millibars, which is about the same as this one. And it seems to be no longer blowing, so it probably doesn't go any further. So it reaches about 8% of the normal pressure, which can be useful for some experiments, but it's definitely far from a perfect vacuum. And this one is very silent, especially when it reaches the maximum vacuum. Now let's try to disconnect it. is the air gonna come back through it. Now the compressor is off and it doesn't move, so it seems it doesn't leak much. There is still almost the same vacuum in it, which is nice. You don't even have to have a valve on it. After about half an hour, there is about 120 millibars, so it doesn't seem to leak much. Now let's try to put the two compressors in a chain. The idea is that if the first one has to pump against lower pressure, it can reach a better vacuum. So this one is the first one connected to the gauge, and the output of it goes into the input of the other one. Let's connect the hose to it. I hope it's gonna be tight enough. And it goes into the other one and then it goes out via this air filter and oil container. Now I have basically two compressors in series, and can I get a lower pressure like this? Because this one is now pumping against much lower pressure, so can it reach a better vacuum like this? Let's try it. So let's power up both of the compressors. It's all running now and the pressure is going down. Now it's about half of the ambient pressure, or 40%, 30%. I hope nothing is gonna explode here. About 20%. Still going down. Now it's almost reaching 10%, and is it gonna go any further? 8%, and still going slightly down, so it's getting better than just one compressor. Now it's about 60 millibars. So it's already a little bit better than just one compressor. And still going down a little bit, about 50 millibars. It seems to be about 40 millibars, which is about half of the pressure with just one compressor. So I'm reaching about 40 millibars, or about 4% of the ambient pressure. Now let's try to use this one as the first one and this one as the second one. So let's rearrange it. Now this one is going into the gauge. My camera just ran out of memory, so let's continue. I'm connecting the gauge to this one. And the output of this one goes into this one. So let's test it. It's going down. And I have to mention that since yesterday, the ambient pressure went down a little bit, so the perfect vacuum on this scale is also moving a little bit to the right. Here I've got my weather station in a floppy disk box, and it shows the temperature, the relative humidity, and the pressure in hectopascals or millibars. So yesterday the pressure was 1000 millibars, today it is 975 millibars, which means that the perfect vacuum is gonna move a little bit to the right. So the pressure went about 25 millibars down. So now the ambient is not 1000 millibars, but about 25 millibars less. So the perfect vacuum has moved about 1 1/4 divisions to the right. Which means I have about 40 millibars here. So it's the same result as yesterday with the compressors the other way. It doesn't move anymore. And if I subtract 25 millibars from it, it gives me about 40 millibars. So I was able to achieve about 80 millibars with one compressor or about 40 millibars with two compressors. But I have to say that this gauge is probably not very accurate and it doesn't say anything about the accuracy. I would expect it to say something like plus minus so many percent or plus minus so many millibars. But this one doesn't say anything about the accuracy of it. And it's a relative gauge, so you can't say where the perfect vacuum is on the scale, because it changes with the ambient pressure. So for example, at a sea level where the pressure is about 1 bar, a perfect vacuum will show up as minus 1. But if you go to mountains, about 5400 meters, the air pressure is about half a bar. So a perfect vacuum will show up as minus half a bar. So the perfect vacuum is at the left side of the scale at a sea level, but it's about in the middle of the scale in the mountains. And the air pressure also slightly changes with the weather, so you can't really say where a perfect vacuum is on the scale. And the closer you get to the perfect vacuum, the more inaccurate the gauge is. So this measurement is really just a very rough estimate. So this is Diagon Wild and see you in my next videos. And in the next video, I'm going to test my very cheap poor man's vacuum chamber.